गुड आफ्टरनून, एम आई ऑडिबल?
सर,
ओके, सो दिस इज द वीडियो लेक्चर ऑन पाइथन जांगो फुल स्टैक वेब डेवलपमेंट. वी आर करेंटली डिस्कसिंग विद द बैक एंड कॉन्सेप्ट्स द पाइथन प्रोग्रामिंग. So in Python programming, we have seen the basic data structures like list, tuple, dictionary, etc. So in the previous session, we have discussed about the Python functions. So that is how you call a function, called function, how to define a function and all. So in this current lecture, you are going to discuss the new concept, that is Python strings. Okay, so before the function only, the string concept will be there. So let's we discuss with the strings concept. So let's see what is the string. Okay, the strings are almost the most popular type of data type in Python. So this data type is used for both the characters. Okay, so characters, single character or group of characters. Okay, so that one we are going to use the string concept. So we can create them by simply enclosing the characters in quotes. So you can create a string by simply enclosing them within single quotes or double quote. So when you compare the string or character, so in C or C++, the single character will be given in single quotes. Group of character or a string will be given in double quotes. But in Python, we treat single quotes same as double quotes. So both can be used for a single character or also a group of characters also. So this will show you how to create a string. So creating the string is simple as assigning a value to a variable. So here you can see, we have taken two strings, hello and world, enclosed in single quotes. And also we have taken two strings, enclosed it in double quotes. So that is the difference. So here it is in single quote and here it is in double quote. And that has been stored in a variable called var1 and var2. So var1 is of type string and var2 is of type string. Okay. So next, you come for the string literals. So each and every string, what you are going to give the statement will be surrounded by either single quotation mark or double quotation mark. So that is given as this, print double quote hello, print single quote hello. So inside the print is one of the function. So function is taking one of the parameter. Parameter can be a string also. So, but while giving the string, give it in terms of the single quotation or double quotation marks. Okay, so that one we call it a string literal. So come for the next one, assign the string to a variable. So here you can go with this example. What is a string? Hello world is the string and that is been assigned to variable var1. Similarly, Python programming is a string that is been assigned to the variable var2. So what do you mean by a variable? Variable contains is an identifier which contains a value. Okay. So now you are going to give the value for a variable. So here you see assign string to a variable. So what is a variable we have taken? Name is the variable. For that you have assigned the value called some name. Okay, so this one we call it a string because it is a group of characters. So totally there are four characters and that is been assigned to the variable called name. And finally, we are going to print that variable contents of the variable using print of name. Okay, so that is the concept of assigning strings to the variable. So which is the string? This content, what you have given in double quotes or single quotes, that will be the string. And you are assigning it to a variable. So name is the variable. So which contains a string value, this one. Okay. So finally, you are going with a print statement here. So now you come for the next line, multi-line strings. So in this example, how many lines the string is there? Yes, can you answer? So in this, this is a string, right? How many lines are there here, string? So yes, it is only one line. So here also, how many lines of string are there? Only one line. So if there is only one line, you can make use of single quotes or double quotes. But if you are having multi-line, so example, you can see this is a multi-line. How many lines you are having? 1, 2, 3, 4. So if it is a multi-line string, then assign the multi-line string by using 3 single quotes or 3 double quotes. So this is a multi-line you have taken. If you are taking a string value in multiple lines, so then you have to use 3 single quotes or you have to use 3 double quotes. If you have started with a 3 double quotes here, you should end with 3 double quotes. If you have started with 3 single quotes, you should end with the 3 single quotes. Okay. So this when we call it as multi-line. So keep in your mind, string means what you are going to give in double quotes, that we consider it as string. Okay. So if that string is of 2 to 3 lines or more number of lines, more than one, so at that time you are going to use 3 double quotes or 3 single quotes. And finally, you are printing that particular variable. Okay. So that is the concept of multi-line strings. So now you come for the concept, the strings as arrays. So like any other programming language, so single character A, it is considered a string. A single word apple is also considered a string. Python does not have character data type. So I am telling you, in C and C++, if you take A, you can, if you are taking a string A, you can have carry data type. Okay. If you are taking apple as word, you have string data type. But the Python does not have a character data type. If it is a single character, if it is a group of characters, everything we are going to concentrate as strings only. Okay, so that is the difference what we have. So strings as arrays. So strings as arrays, I have taken one string, I have given the value. So if you want to represent the string as arrays, so that particular variable, what is the variable you have taken? Name. So name should make use of arrays. So name of 0, first character, name of 1, second character, name of 2, third character, like that. So you can access the individual character by using arrays inside the strings. Okay. So now you come for the next topic, slicing. So come for this example. So here, if I give print name of 1, what will be the output? Yes, answer here. What can be the output here? Name of 1.
K.
K. If I want B, what I should give?
Name of 2.
Name of 2. Okay. If I want H?
Name of 0.
Okay, suppose if I want these two characters. So till now in the arrays using strings, you have taken fetched only the first character, second character, third character, like that. So suppose I want the first two characters. If you want
one
first two characters,
three.
So then
one
you go
two.
With a, pardon? Yes.
1:2.
Okay. So that concept we are going to have, that is called as a slicing. So suppose if you want a range of characters, so you can return a range of characters by using slice syntax. So for that, specify the first index and also the last index. So separated by colon to return a part of the string. So if you want the range of the characters, then you are going to use the slice syntax. So specify the start index and the end index separated by a colon to return a part of the string. So for example, here I have taken a multi-line string because I have taken 1, 2, 3, 4 lines total. So 4 lines, we are going to use multi-line comment. For multi-line string, it should be started with 3 double quotes and ended with 3 double quotes. Now I am taking 3:11. So if I take 3:11, it will start at location 3 and it will end at 10th location. So it will not print the 11th location character. 3:11, it will start at the location 3 and end at location 10. Okay, so which is the location 3? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So only this part will be printed. Okay. So that is the concept of slicing. So similarly, now you come for the negative index. So this one, we call it as index values 3:11. So this is called positive index. So come for the negative index. So negative index to start the slice from the end of the string. So if you want end of the string, E is the first character. It is having position -1, -1, -2. If you take like this, so it will start with -1 last character and end at 8th character from last. So one first character -1 will be printed, -2, -3, -4, -5, -6, -7, -8, -9. So up to this part, the string will be printed. So that is the concept of negative index. So now you come for the next operation, string length. So in order to find the length of the string, so it will define the length of the given string. So output will be in terms of integer data type. Okay, so I'm taking a string A in multi-line string, so len of A. So it will print the total number of characters, everything inside your string. So that one will be printed here. So len function will print the total number of characters present in this particular string. So come for the next one, string methods. So there are so many methods in the string. So first one is strip. So string methods, first we have strip. It removes any white spaces from the beginning or at the end. So here I have given so many spaces and here in the ending also I have given so many spaces. So strip method will remove any white spaces if the white space is there at the starting or if the white space is there at the end, so that one will be removed. So if you take a.strip, it will show you the contents without any white spaces. Okay. So next method is lower method. It returns the string in lowercase. So here I have taken some characters in the uppercase. So lower function will convert all the characters in lowercase. So how you call that one? A.lower. Similarly, upper method returns the string in uppercase. So I have taken the A multi-line string and give A.upper. So it will convert all the characters present in the string to uppercase. So next one, replace method. So replace method replaces its original string with some other string. Okay, so for that you take a string and then call a function a dot replace with ms comma something. So this is original content replace string, and what should be replaced? So I am replacing some text with a blank space here. So this is a blank space. So in place of these two characters, you'll be having a blank space. Okay. So this is the one of the methods. So next we have split method. So split, it will take a string S and convert it into substrings. Okay. So on what condition the split will be obtained? So we are going to apply the split when you encounter comma. So here you can see, so to divide a string into substrings, so on what condition you are going to split? So for that one, you are taking split of comma. So whenever the comma will occur, the string will be divided into sub. Okay. So when you divide, the first substring will be first one, second substring will be second, and third substring will be third name. Okay, so that's how you are going to call a split function on a string A. So next come for the some of the functions. So first one, to check whether the character is there or not in the string. So for that I have taken a character. So inside that I have taken some names. So to check whether the input X is there or not. So what you give here X1, this one is called X2, and this one is called X3. If this key value is there or not. So for that one, you take X is equal to name in string. Understand carefully, it should be string character in string. So if you give print X, it will show whether it is there or not. Okay. So next you come for the string concatenation. To concatenate or combine two strings, you can use the plus operator. So first you have to take the first string. I have taken F, that is first name. And next string I have taken it as L, last name. So then I have taken full name is equal to F plus L. Okay. So F plus L. So print of Fn, it will print full name. Okay. So how to concatenate two strings? Take the string one plus string two. Okay. So if you didn't give this plus double quote, so after the N only, after this N, so this N will come. So in order to have the space between these two strings, you are making use of space here. Okay. So you can simply give F plus L. You will get the output. No problem. But the thing is, there is no separation between the two strings. To need the separation, you are going to add a blank space between the first and second string. So this can be given by this. So now you see, here the first string is also character, second string is also string. So suppose if you are concatenating two strings with one string containing integer value and the other string containing string, so is it possible? Yes, answer to the question. So in this example, we have taken two strings only and you have joined with a concatenation using plus. Suppose I take name with age. So name being Manoj, age being 32. So can you join these two using this concatenation? Yes, can you join? No. Why? What's the problem? Can you join a string with a number? That is the concept I'm asking. So come for here. So here you take this example. Don't go for any of the description. Take this example. I've taken three strings, first name, last name, and age. Okay. So now I have taken full name is equal to first name plus last name. And then I have taken full name is equal to full name plus age. So is it possible? So will it show the first name as well as last name with age? Is it possible, this particular line? Because full name is containing a string and age is containing a number. So we can't combine the string with a number like this. Understood? So you can concatenate two numbers using plus. You can concatenate two strings using plus, but you can't concatenate string with a number using plus. That is the concept. So here you can see, you cannot combine strings and numbers like this, but you can combine the strings and numbers by using a function called format method. Okay. So you can't combine using plus, but you can make use using format method. So what's the change you are going? Take the first name, take the last name, take the age, and take the first name also. So now I have taken text is equal to, this is the format, text.format of full name comma age. So you can take like this as a statement. So at that time, it will show you student name, first flower bracket will show you the first name and second flower bracket will show you the age. Okay. So for that, you can make use of format method. Format method is used to combine the strings as well as numbers. So that is the examples till now we have seen. So you can take the parameters like this also, 0 and 1. Okay. So now you come for the escape character. So suppose you are taking a string. So that contains double quotes within another double quotes. So here you can see, so within double quotes, you are getting another double quotes here. So if you execute this statement, you will get an error. Okay, because in between the double quotes, there is nothing here. So double quotes followed with double quotes will lead to an error. To fix this problem, we use a concept called escape character. Okay, so that one can be taken by using this slash. So just the same thing, slash double quote you have to use. So that is the concept of escape. Next, built-in string methods. So some of the string methods, what we have seen, first one is lowercase, lower function, upper function, split function, strip function, len function, etc. So apart from all those methods, there is a concept called string conversion. Okay, so take this example, n is equal to 3, 4, 5. So print n, it will print the value. Print type of n. So can you tell what is the data type, whether this one belongs to integer or this one belongs to string? N is of integer data type or string data type?
String, because we use double quotes.
It is in, if you simply give n is equal to 3, 4, 5, it belongs to integer. But the thing is, you are enclosed it in double quotes. So if you give it in double quotes, it will be in the string data type. So print type of n, it will print it as string because it is in the double quotes. Now I am going to convert that n into integer. So how to convert into integer? You give it as int of n. So int of n. So take this value and store it in n1 and print the type of n1. So now n1 is belonging to integer. So type of n1 will take you to integer. Okay. So similarly, you can go with this example. variable you have taken, roll number, you are assigned a value. So if you are going for a print of RNO, so print type of RNO, it will display string. Now the string has been converted into integer and assigned to RNO1. So now give print type of RNO1. So it will print it as integer. Okay. So that is the string conversion. So next you come for the string and secret codes. So there are two functions. One is the odd function, the other one is CHR function. Odd function returns the numerical code of a character. So that means if you want the ASCII value of any of the character, you should make use of odd function. Okay. So to convert a numerical code into character, you make use of CHR function. CHR means character. So give the character for ASCII value 65. Okay. Suppose if you want the ASCII value, so give odd of A. Odd of A, it will print you the ASCII value. So CHR of 65 will convert a numeric code to character. These are the two functions to get the ASCII value. So next you use the string center method. So center returns the centered in the string of the width. So here you can see text, this is that string what I have taken. Now I have called text.center. So you can remember there is a concept called padding. What the padding will do, padding will add extra space before and after the string. What the padding will do, it will add the extra bytes of space before the character, before the string and after the string. So now you can tell text.center of 100. So 100 characters of the space is taken before the T will start. And after K is finished, 100 characters of the space will be occupied. So that is the concept of center function. So next you come with ends with. So ends with will return true if the string ends with a suffix, otherwise returns false. So I have taken the string text dot ends with of dot. So is our string is ending with dot? See here. Is it ending with dot? So whether it is ending with dot?
No, sir.
No. So if you give dot here, it will return the function as true. If it is not ending with a dot, so the condition will return false. Okay. So next you come for the find method. So find whether a substring is present inside a string. Okay. So this is the string we have taken. So next I have taken text.find of HTTP. So here is this substring is present here. So what is the substring I have taken? This is a substring. So check whether this substring is present in your string. If it is present, return the index. So what is the index? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it will print of x. It will return the index value of that particular substring. So index value of the substring, it is starting at 5. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So print of x, it will print 5. Okay. So next we have replace. So already we have seen. So take a string, replace the substring with some other string. So substring, you give it first. Some other string, you give it next. So when you give print of x, it will show you in place of the substring, you'll be getting the word conference. Okay. So that is the replace method. Okay, this is up to strings with methods and various operations. So have you understood up to here? Is understood? Okay. So all these things, okay. So all these things are up to string, multi-line characters, string operations, and some of the string methods. Okay. So go through these particular sessions. So work in the Google Colab and understand each and every concept of range, negative index, string operations. Okay. So work on the Google Colab and see. So this is up to string concepts. So tomorrow class, we will be having a new concept, file handling. Okay. So this is this video lecture will be uploaded in my YouTube channel. Kindly go through, work using Google Colab. Kindly like, share, subscribe for the channel. Okay, thank you. Meet you in the next class.